Hello everyone and welcome back to Axis and Allies. Last time we did, well, not conquer the world, but conquer most of Eurasia as the Soviets. This time we're going to play as the Germans. And I'm going to leave the rest of the nations at the 5-star AI. So, let's begin. So the Russians start. And should I retreat? You know what? Let's remain. Let's remain. Oh, and we lost our submarine, I guess. Wait, is that actually a transport? No, I don't think it is. Well, I guess we won that battle. And the Russians don't really do anything else. We are going to buy a lot of infantry. So we have, at the Germans, we control Southern Europe, which is pretty awesome, I guess. And also Western Europe, both of which are pretty valuable. We also are active in Scandinavia, which may or may not be worth defending. And we do want control over Karelia, that's pretty crucial. I could attack Karelia, I've got 9 infantry and a whole bunch of tanks and other stuff. You know what, I might actually risk that. So because, actually, yeah, you know what, let's just do that. We might actually do that. Let's send everything against the Russians here, because they lose Karelia. It's actually pretty, it's pretty bad for them, so. So we've got a lot more tanks, we have less infantry, but we can also bring these guys over here. And we can bring you, so yeah, this might actually work. Let's bring you over as well, so. Bit of a gamble, but hey. I gamble pretty much all the time here. So the question is, do we want to attack the British here? We could. The thing is, we should probably... Yeah, you know what, let's also try to blitz through Africa here. This is again a little bit of a gamble, but let's just see how it goes. So we take Equatorial Africa, we take French West Africa, and let's see whether we take Egypt. Oh, obviously not. Very obviously not. That was complete failure. Let's see how this goes. Why can't I... Oh, AA guns. Oh, that's not good. Well, that's not good either, but at least the Russians lost a good... Ooh, ooh. Yeah, this is not great, but they lost a lot of stuff here. They definitely lost a lot of stuff here. There we go, Karelia is ours. Question is, can we hold it? So non-combat move. Let's move you back home. And... So let's actually move you guys over here. And you guys over here because... We can... Let's place like... 3 guys here just to be sure, and let's place the rest here. And we collect 37 IPCs, not bad. The Russians are probably going to march in here, but that's how things work. So let's see what the British do. Yeah, they will reconquer Africa. That's too bad. And I guess that's it. Well, but we exchanged that for a plane, so I guess that's awesome. And we shot down a bomber, not bad. So let's see how this naval battle here goes. And let's see, maybe we can... Oh yeah, we can sink them, so... Well, the Mediterranean is now clear. Of everybody, not just me. Let's actually submerge. So we lose that battle, but at least our submarine is still intact. So... Japan takes India, which was apparently completely abandoned. And that's pretty much it. The Americans probably are not going to do too much. Because they can't... Okay, this again. And yeah, here goes our Navy. Well, that happens. German war machine on the move. Yeah, we are on the move. The Japanese are on the move. And the Allies, part of the Americans, are on the move downwards. Yeah, that was bound to happen. So, but that's okay. So let's skip this and let's buy a lot of infantry. 13 infantry, not bad. So I can actually totally take... Yeah, I can place more guys in Karelia to secure it because there's like 17 infantry here. And I can march. I can actually send two tanks here because I can... And these planes here. That should do it for now. Yeah, the British don't really have a lot of transports here, so they aren't really threatening Europe too much. I need to secure... Let's put two more guys... A couple more guys here. I really don't want to lose Western Europe. That's... If that happens, that's super annoying. And I might lose Scandinavia too. But I can only allocate so many resources to it, and it's more important than that we kick the Russians out of the war. And one tank for pretty much nothing. That's pretty good. So non-combat moves, you're going to move... Actually, I can move you here. So... Oh, yeah, I can only move so many guys in here. That's one of the downsides of conquering Karelia. The Russians can put pretty much whatever units they want in there, because that's actually not good. I thought it was worth more. But anyway, they can put a lot of stuff in there because it's one of their core provinces. Which is not true for me, and yeah, this was bound to happen. And wow, we actually blew up a tank. In your face, UK. So, Japan is threatening the Soviets, which is pretty good. We can probably roll them up in a couple of turns. And they're again taking Alaska. They just love to do that. Yeah, Japan is really hot for Alaska and Canada. And let's just see whether the Americans are actually going to take that back. No, they are not. Japanese military gains momentum. Yeah, it's again going okay. Let's see what the Russians are doing this time. Not a whole lot, actually. But they're stacking up units. They're stacking up units in there. I could also buy a whole bunch of tanks here. That might actually be better. Well, let's just buy a whole bunch of tanks, because why not? So what I'm going to do here is, yeah, the allies are going to stack up forces here. I don't really like that. So let's actually try to kick them out. I can put three more tanks in here after this round. And the question is, do I want to, I kind of want to advance these guys here too, but I should do that once I've built the tanks and moved them a little bit forward, yeah. So here it's seven of my tanks against three tanks and these guys here. Just put one guy in here to absorb some damage. Maybe do it like this. So let's move you here. And you can, actually you can join here. And I don't want you to... can you... What, nope. Here we go. You can fly here directly. Thank you. So... You can actually, you can conquer Morocco here and Algeria, because why not? And anything else? Actually, you can join here as well. So that's a lot of boats. That's a lot of boats. So by the way, Ireland in this game owns Northern Ireland because they couldn't be bothered to draw this properly. So, and I should probably. Yeah, move some guys here, because I have to put a lot of tanks here anyway. So yeah, the Japanese are doing quite well. They're probably going to waltz through the Middle East, and the Russian their flank here is pretty weak. The Japanese are kind of weak here as well, but that's okay. I mean the Russians, they have lost a lot of IPCs, so that's worth something as well. So let's attack you guys, and you're all dead. So, and I'm actually going to sacrifice a tank here. So you can... Okay, that's still combat, so non-combat move. You can move over here, you can move over here, and you can move over here, I guess. So you guys get in here, and I may as well place you here. It doesn't really make much of a difference. And 36 IPCs, not bad. Let's see whether the British pull anything here. Nope, not really. Yeah, I'm going to need a really large fleet to sink that Allied fleet in the Atlantic. Japanese take Midway with tanks. 40 IPCs, not bad. Do we actually outproduce the Allies? Not quite, I think. But that's okay. Once we have smashed Russia, it's going to look really grim for the Allies. So, and that was all right, I guess. So let's skip this. Let's actually build a whole bunch of these guys here again. And they are building up a massive force here. Actually going to reinforce this front here and this one here. And may as well put some tanks here. And do I want... They have a lot of guys here, but then again they only have so many transports, so that's another thing. Yeah. Oh wait, actually we have a whole bunch of tanks here. We should definitely move guys over here. And then move some tanks over here. Let's maybe leave one tank here. So they can invade me here, but it's going to cost them something, so. And no combat this time. Well, yeah, I've had my chance there anyway. No non-combat. And let's place like three guys here. That's another thing where tanks can be quite attractive. They're more expensive, but you can put three of them here, which are worth more than the three infantry units you can also put there. So no real progress, but we're building up. So, oh. Western Europe, yeah, that was bound to happen. And at least they're losing more stuff than I am losing. That's good. Oh yeah, they're losing way more stuff than I'm losing. But I need to reinforce Western Europe. Ooh, that's really bad for them. Wow, they lost. That was pretty devastating. Yeah, that was not good for them. They wasted a lot of stuff. And Japanese really like to take Panama. And they take a lot of stuff today. And their industry is exploding. So, and the Americans also like to keep Panama and Alaska. And they do advance indeed. After they lost, well, they did conquer stuff that they lost. Oh, and Russia is really shrinking. They can still produce 4 infantry per round, but it's not that great. Still want more infantry for now. So I definitely need to reinforce Western Europe here. Because they're still building up here again, so. Should I actually go for... I could actually advance these guys here. I'm not sure why I haven't done that already. But that's going to cost them some guys. May as well bring you in and... Yeah, that should be sufficient. Anything else? I could move against these guys, but I don't really want to. These guys seem to be passive, and I'm kind of okay with that. I can build some transport later and then swoop through the Mediterranean, but not right now. So let's fight this out. And they're all dead. And I lost some guys. There we go. The Caucasus is ours. Caucasus, which almost bought us Moscow. So anything else? Not really. Okay. Oh yeah, you need to move. You need to move. Here we go. Three guys here. And let's actually put a couple of guys here just in case. And the rest... come on. Stop that. And the rest of the guys here. 39 IPCs. Yeah, Japan and me together have more than 80 IPCs, which is pretty good. And the UK does not do another invasion, which is good. And Japan is just taking over everything. They go out of control. And the Americans don't really do anything. And let's see what the Soviets do this time. Not a whole lot, because they barely have anything left. So let's skip this. Let's actually build more armor. So let's move a couple of these guys here. Actually, yeah, this should be sufficient. And I've got 14 infantry and 12 tanks against 30 infantry. and to planes. So the question is, do I want to do that? It's a bit risky. I mean, I could build up more, but they are also building up. Well, I can also move in this tank here. Yeah, let's do it. We have to do it at one point. And at least the Russians, they should suffer, or the Soviets, they should suffer pretty severe losses in any case. So, yeah, let's just do it. So, ooh, yeah, and we are going to suffer a lot of losses as well. Yeah, this might have been a bad idea. Yeah, might have been a really bad idea. Four versus, ooh. Yeah, this was a bad idea. Japan might actually then conquer, yeah. There was my forces, but then again, so that was repelled. Of course, that was bad, because it now actually, I can't move these guys. So let's put you guys here, and let's put you guys here. They might gain some ground, but then again, Japan might actually steamroll them. And their economy is still weak. So, Finland, Norway. Ooh, yeah, this was a bad time to do what I did. But I'm going to reconquer all of that. No worries. So, Japan is conquering Africa, which is great. And okay, looks like the Japanese try to conquer Russia as well, as in Russia. Okay. Wait, did we already have an economic victory? If we did, that came very sudden. Okay. I thought you'd have to conquer at least all of, pretty much all of Eurasia, with the exception of the UK and Africa. Okay, but I guess that was enough for an economic victory. So there we go. We almost conquered the entire Soviet Union, but we didn't conquer a single allied capital, but I guess that was enough. So yeah, that went pretty well, despite me thinking it didn't really went all that well, but hey, there we go. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time when we play as the British. Take care and goodbye.